house, and I thought I'd surprise him with a little bit of a romantic surprise meal. We're gonna start with making a red wine braised short rib. I'm gonna make a caprese salad, a little bit of a scallop pasta, and finish it off with a delicious creme brulee. So basically, I'm gonna teach you guys how to make a really romantic, impressive meal under an hour and a half. Let's get started. So we're gonna start with making our short rib. So for our red wine braised short rib, we're gonna need boneless short ribs, onions, carrots, garlic, thyme, cheapest red wine, some honey, and some black pepper and salt. We're gonna start with seasoning our meat and then giving it a sear in our pan. Put oil into your pan and wait for it to get smoky hot. This will give your meat a proper sear. While it's heating up, we're gonna season our meat. Grind some peppercorn on top. And salt. This is the only time we'll really get to season our meat instead of reducing the sauce, so it's important to get a nice covering of seasoning. Evenly and completely. Place your meat into the pan, thick side down. And now you're not gonna wanna move your meat at all because you wanna get that caramelization on top of your meat. That's where the flavor is gonna come from. Also, for my vegetables, I have rough chopped carrots, rough chopped onions, and some whole garlic cloves. We're also gonna season with some herbs. You can use thyme or rosemary. I like the combination of, I like to use just thyme. Once your meat gets a proper sear, we're gonna flip over and sear the other side. You see how it's nice and brown. For thicker pieces, you can also cook a little bit on the side. You can hold the beef on its side to cook the sides as well. This will seal in the moisture and make it for a very tender piece of meat. Once your beef is done searing, we're gonna place it into our Dutch oven. You'll notice that there's a lot of excess oil. We're gonna dump this and sear our vegetables with the beef fond. Again, the purpose isn't to cook our vegetables, it's to caramelize them for flavor. You almost want to get a nice brown color, golden brown color on your vegetables. And you'll see the onions, since they have a higher sugar content, will caramelize faster. It's important to use a heavy bottom pan so you can get a proper sear on your vegetables as well. Don't use anything non-stick. Those pans generally don't heat up fast enough. Now we're going to deglaze with half a bottle of red wine, or more if you prefer a stronger red wine taste. Use a wooden spatula to scrape the bottom to take off all that excess beef flavor. And we're going to pour all of this into our Dutch oven. Pot is nice and clean. Now we're gonna cover the beef with either beef broth or water. I recommend using beef broth, but I'm out, so I'm gonna use water. Cover and boil. We're gonna bring to a high rolling boil. Prepare a bowl of water as we're gonna need to skim off the impurities. Also season with some thyme to simmer. We're also gonna add in about a fourth cup of honey. Honey is a protease and will break down the protein fibers of the beef for a more tender beef and also a sweeter stock. Make sure to get all the honey in. As it boils, we're gonna skim off some of the impurities from the top. This is actually denatured protein and it generally creates a murkier sauce. So the more you skim off, the clearer your sauce will be at the end. Having a bowl of water ready to skim the impurities makes it much easier. In French and Japanese cuisine, it's vital to skim off the impurities. So I would do this whenever you cook or reduce a sauce or make a stock. Okay, once all the impurities are gone, we're gonna cover it and simmer on a medium to medium low fire for as long as it takes to become soft. If you have a pressure cooker, it may only take you 30 minutes. If you have a Dutch oven, it may take an hour to an hour and a half. So So next we're gonna make a simple but impressive looking salad, and it's also extremely delicious, a caprese salad. We only need 4 ingredients, which is balsamic reduction, cherry tomatoes, basil, and mini fresh mozzarella pearls. Let's make this. We're gonna keep our smaller pieces of tomato, and we're gonna cut our larger pieces lengthwise. I chose multicolored tomatoes because honestly it's prettier. Looks more impressive on a dish. Cut lengthwise. Always use fresh mozzarella for caprese. It tastes much better. I chose pearls because they're similar size to the tomatoes and it's cuter. Okay, we're gonna plate our tomatoes. Make sure to plate in a very lovely fashion. It's all nice. Okay, we're gonna save the rest for another day. We're gonna plate some basil leaves on top. Not only is it a garnish, it also tastes wonderful with the caprese salad. I like to plate with the leaves slightly facing up. It adds more volume to a plate. It's one plating technique 101. Okay, and this is how you make a simple salad look like fine dining. We're gonna drizzle on some of this balsamic reduction. A perfectly plated caprese salad. Okay, so now our beef short rib has reduced and it is fork tender. So now we're gonna take out the beef short rib and we're gonna reduce the remaining sauce. Remove the vegetables and the aromatics and place into the trash. We're gonna reduce this sauce until it can coat the back of the spoon. So not quite yet. All right, we're gonna salt. About a pinch and a half of salt. A common rule of thumb for reducing a sauce is that if it coats the back of the spoon and you can draw a line through with your finger, then the sauce is properly reduced. Now spoon some of this lovely sauce onto your short ribs to finish. Okay, we have some lovely pieces of rosemary to garnish, as well as some thyme to finish. Making a simple dish seem fancy is all about your garnish. Okay, and now we're done with our main course, our red wine braised short rib. Okay, so everything is done and I got my friend Toto here, Marvin. He actually didn't know this was happening. So he already ate. He's a little full. But here, try the salad.
All right. Try the salad. Any specific one you want to try?
It's a caprese salad.
Okay. Let's try a little bit of this. This. Let's try this. Let's try a little bit of basil. Here is the basil.
Normally hate salads. It's a good salad.
It's pretty good. I'm trying it just for her, but I don't hate it.
Oh, yeah.
So it's pretty good.
That's great.
Sure. This is what I'm most excited about. I'm most excited about this one. Alright, let's get this.
Sauce. I did it like
No, it was good. Hold on, before moving on, there are nervous.
So this recipe is super easy to make, and it actually looks quite impressive. So this is something you can make for your friends, a date. Okay, Toto, go eat now.
All right, I'm gonna
Thank
go eat.
Thank you. Eat that, it's like that was most.
I will.
All right, guys, so I successfully surprised my friend, although next time I might warn him to not eat first, or next time I might do a surprise for my roommates. So thank you guys so much for watching my YouTube video on a quick, romantic, or fun recipe idea to make for your friends or a date. Actually, I'm a professional chef who streams I'm a professional chef who streams Monday through Friday, lunch and dinner on Twitch. So if you want to see me cook live, please check out my Twitch. Otherwise, thank you so much for your time. Please comment below what you would like for me to cook in the future, and I'll